In today's video, we'll take a look at how to highlight text and bring your boring old screenshots to life with a camera flyover effect. All this can be done right in Final Cut Pro without the need to download or install any plugins. Before we jump into Final Cut Pro, I just want to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Whether you edit videos for a living or it's just a hobby, a subscription to Envato Elements could be a game changer. It's an all-in-one subscription service that gives you access to over 56 million digital assets. You get unlimited downloads of stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, custom fonts, and so much more. And new items are added every week. Everything Envato Elements has to offer is included for one low monthly fee. This is super helpful if you're trying to grow your business or your YouTube channel and don't have an unlimited budget. Click the link in the video description to see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. First, let's take a look at how to draw attention to a specific part of your screenshot by highlighting text. Grab your screenshot clip and drag it down into your timeline. Next, open the Titles and Generators browser, expand the Generators drop-down menu, and select the Solids category. Grab the Custom Generator clip, drag it down into your timeline, and place it above your screenshot clip. Ripple trim it to the same length as your bottom clip. Press Command 4 to open the inspector window and select the generator's inspector. First thing we want to do is change the color of this generator to the color we want to use for the highlighter. Click on the color square and select the color of your highlighter. I'll use lemon for this demo. To make the text underneath visible, select the video inspector and change the blend mode to darken. Next, let's select the text we want to highlight. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, and in the search bar at the bottom, search for the crop and feather effect. Grab this effect and apply it to your generator clip. In the video inspector, use the height and width sliders to adjust the size of your highlighted area and position controls to place it over the text you want to highlight. You might have to zoom in on the viewer window to more precisely adjust the size and placement of this effect. If you find the adjustment sliders are a bit too sensitive for this, you can always click on the number beside the slider and manually enter a value. After you get your highlighted area exactly where you need it, use a feather slider to feather out the edges and make this look a little more realistic. To animate this highlighter effect, zoom out on your viewer window and place your playhead on the frame you want this effect to start on. From the Transform dropdown under the viewer window, select Crop and click the Trim tool. Grab the handle on the right side of the trim frame and drag it over to the left until it's just to the left side of the effect. Add a keyframe here. Move your playhead ahead about 20 frames and drag the crop handle to the right until your full highlighter effect is revealed. Click Done. Here's what we have so far. Next, let's animate this screenshot with a camera flyover effect to make this look even better. First, Command-click both your clips and use a keyboard shortcut Option G to make them into a compound clip. With a compound clip selected, from the Transform dropdown, select the Distort tool. Zoom out on your viewer window and use the corner handles to add a bit of perspective to your image. If you want this to be symmetrical, in the inspector window, manually adjust the similar values so they're exactly the same. Click Done. Move your playhead to where you want the animation to start. Select the Transform tool and use either the on-screen controls or the sliders in the inspector window to set your starting camera position. Add a keyframe here. Move your playhead to where you want the animation to end and set your end camera position. Right-click on each control point in the viewer window and change the movement type from smooth to linear. Click Done. And last, to make this even more realistic, let's add some depth of focus blur. Select your clip in the timeline and make another compound clip. Go back to the effects browser, select the blurs category, and add the focus blur effect to your clip. With your playhead at the start of your clip, in the inspector, drag the height slider all the way up to 100, and depending on the amount of distortion in your screenshot, adjust the width slider until the blur looks realistic. To make this more subtle, I recommend bringing the amount down to about 15 or 20. Use the on-screen controls to move the center point to an area of your clip you want to be in focus at the start. Make sure this is on the close side of your frame. Add keyframes to all your focus parameters. Next, move your playhead to the end of your clip and move and adjust the focus point until your highlighted text is completely in focus. Here's the shot we started with, and our finished result. And this was all done in Final Cut Pro without any plugins. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.